perform the experiment number 2, that is to determine the particle size and particle size distribution of given powder sample by using optical microscopy method. See here, in today's practical we can use the optical microscopy method, okay? But in last experiment, that is experiment number 1, in that experiment we can use the sieving methods, okay? And by sieving method we can determine the particle size. And in sieving method, the particle size range should be 50 to 1500 micrometer, okay? But in optical microscopy method, here the particle size is very small, okay? The particle size in optical microscopy method in the range between 0.2 to 100 micrometer, okay? So, whatever particle size we have to measure, that particle size should be in between the range 0.2 to 100 micrometer, okay? So, this particle size range we can use in the optical microscopy methods. See here, in optical microscopy method, here we can use the compound microscope, okay? With the help of compound microscope, we can determine the particle size and particle size distributions, okay? So, first of all, we have to discuss the basic introduction about this experiment. See here, the first word micrometers. Micrometers word is related to the particle size distribution and particle size analysis, okay? So, micrometers, it involves the study of small particles and order of few micron size, okay? So, it involves the small size particles. It means, in micrometers topic or in micrometers concept, we have to study the or we get detailed study of the small particles. The particle size should be in the range of micron, okay? The very small size particles is present and we have to determine their particle size and we can determine the, their particle size distributions, okay? It means we can analyze the particle size with the help of micrometrics, okay? And that particle size analysis should be in the range micron, or that particle size is present in the micron size, okay? So, means the micrometrics word is related to the particle size and particle size distribution analysis purpose, okay? So, next point, here in optical microscopy, the microscopy we have to use, or compound microscope we can use. So, in the microscope, it mostly used to, or with the help of microscope, it directly visualize the particle. Very small particle we can easily visualize with the help of microscope, because the small particle we cannot view with the help of our naked eyes, okay? So, we can use the microscope for that purpose, okay? So, this is the most useful, microscope is mostly useful for to directly visualize the very small particle, that is the particle in the micron size, okay? The size, you know, in last experiment, the size is expressed as a diameter. We can determine the particle size and that particle size is expressed in diameter, okay? So, in optical microscopy, here the particle size is expressed as projected diameter. In sieving method, the particle size is expressed as sieve diameter. Okay? In optical microscope, here the particle size is expressed as projected diameter. This is the difference. Sieving method, sieve diameter is present, and in optical microscopy, projected diameter is present. Okay? So it gives the in optical microscopy, it first gives the number distribution and then it converts into the weight distribution. It means in optical microscopy, we have to count the number of particles in between the range, in between the 0 to 30 range or 30 to 60 range or 60 to 90 range, we can count the number of particles and with the help of that count number, we can determine the particle size. And after that, that number distribution we can convert into the weight distribution in optical microscopy. But in sieving method, in that they are directly use the weight distribution. It means in sieving method we have to directly take the weight of different particle sizes and determine the particle size. But in optical microscopy, here we have to first count the number of particles, then this number distribution we can convert into the weight distributions. Okay? See here, what is the application or what is the use of optical microscopy? The optical microscopy is mostly determine the particle size of mostly or many formulations. Okay, it is mostly useful to determine the particle size of formulations of suspensions, aerosols, or globule size in immersions. It means in immersion globules are present. That globules particle size we can easily determine with the help of optical microscopy, because that globule size we can easily visualize small size particles, and that particle size we can determine with the help of optical microscopy method. This is the most useful applications. Okay. Then next point, advantages of the optical microscopy. When we can use the optical microscopy method with the help of microscopy, we can easily view the particles directly. Okay. We have with the help of eyepiece, we can easily view the particle size directly. Then second advantage, if the in that sample or in formulations agglomeration is present or any contamination is present, that contamination we can easily determine with the help of microscope, okay, or we can easily detect it, okay, because in microscope we can easily view the small size particle also. So if that formulation contains some contamination or agglomeration, we can easily detect it, okay. Then these advantages, optical microscopy contains some advantages also and disadvantages also. So the next point is the disadvantages. In disadvantages, the diameter is obtained, we can use the optical microscopy to determine the particle size, okay. So for determination of particle size, we can determine the diameter, okay. So the diameter is obtained from only two directions. With the help of optical microscopy, we can determine the diameter in only two directions. So which two directions? That is the length and breadth. Means with the help of length and breadth, we can determine the diameter. But depth of the particle is not measurable. It means here the depth of the particle we cannot measure with the help of microscope. This is the disadvantages. Okay. Second disadvantage is this method is very slow and tedious. This method requires very longer time and it is a tedious method. Okay. So this is the basic introduction of the optical microscopy method. So for determination of particle size and particle size distribution, the first step of the procedure is calibration of the eyepiece micrometer. This is the first step. How we can calibrate the eyepiece micrometer? Eyepiece micrometer we can use to determine the particle size. So before we have to use the eyepiece micrometer, we have to calibrate that eyepiece micrometer. Okay. So what is the calibration? Calibration, it is the actual size or actual length in between the two lines. We can determine the actual length between the two lines or actual length between the two divisions. See here in this diagram, the eyepiece micrometer contains the 100 divisions and stage micrometer also contains the 100 division. Okay. So in eyepiece micrometer, 100 division is present. So what is the division? Division means the space between the two lines. Space between the two lines, that is called as the one division. So in between the two lines, many space is present. So this space is called as the 100 lines is present. So in between the two lines, one division is present. Okay. So eyepiece micrometer contains the 100 division and stage micrometer is also contains the 100 division. So what is the division? Division, it is the space between the two lines. Okay. So for calibration purpose, or what is the calibration? Calibration is the actual length between the two lines or actual length between the divisions. Okay. So what is the actual length in between the divisions? For that purpose, we have, or for calibration purpose, we can use the eyepiece micrometer, and that eyepiece micrometer number of divisions we have to overlap it with the number of divisions with stage micrometer. Means the eyepiece micrometer number of divisions we have to overlap with stage micrometer divisions. Means we have to coincide these lines, we can stage micrometer lines we have to coincide with eyepiece micrometer lines, and that eyepiece micrometer lines or eyepiece micrometer scale is very small as compared to the stage micrometer scale. Okay, so we have to coincide the stage micrometer line with the eyepiece micrometer line. Calibration procedure of the eyepiece micrometer. For that purpose, we have to use the 10x eyepiece. Okay, this is the 10x eyepiece, and in this eyepiece, the scale is present. That is the eyepiece micrometer scale. Okay, we can insert here. Then we have to use the stage micrometer scale. This is the stage micrometer scale. Millimeter scale. Okay. See here, this is the 1 millimeter stage micrometer scale. We have to place on the stage. After that, we can calibrate the eyepiece micrometer. Okay. See here, the eyepiece micrometer scale is coincide with the stage micrometer scale. Okay. So here the calibration procedure is complete. coincide with the 55 number lines of the eyepiece micrometer. Okay, and here the 10 number divisions of the stage micrometer is coincide with the 83 number lines of the eyepiece micrometer. Okay, and after the coincides these two micrometers, then we have to count the number of lines of the eyepiece micrometer. These number of lines of eyepiece micrometers are involves or are included in the 9 to 10 division of the stage micrometer. Okay, so we can count the number of lines of the eyepiece micrometer in between the 9 to 10, and we have to count the number of lines of the stage micrometer in between the 9 to 10. Okay, so for calibration purpose, we have to use the number of divisions of eyepiece micrometer should be equal to the number of divisions of stage micrometer. Okay, see here the number of divisions of stage micrometer, this is, and this is the number of divisions of eyepiece micrometer. Okay, then number of divisions of eyepiece micrometer give the name A, and number of divisions of stage micrometer give the name B. Okay, so here we have to calculate the one division of eyepiece micrometer. What is the one division? One division means in between the two lines the space is present, that in between the two lines that space we can call as a one division. Okay, so we have to determine the one division length, actual length in between the one, actual length in the one divisions. Okay, so one division of eyepiece micrometer determination is equals to determination of one division of eyepiece micrometer, it is equals to B upon A. B means the number of division of stage micrometer upon A, number of division of eyepiece micrometer, multiplied by least count. Okay, you know the number of division of stage micrometer. Number of division of stage micrometer, that is this one. So count the number of lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Total 10 divisions is present in the stage micrometer. See here, space between the two lines. One division, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. Total 10 division is present in stage micrometer. So here we have to write the 10. Then number of division of eyepiece micrometer. Count the number of divisions of eyepiece micrometer. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In between the two lines, that is the one division. Okay. So in eyepiece micrometer, the division is 28. Okay. So in 10 division of stage micrometer, it includes the 28 division of eyepiece micrometer. They should be equal. Okay. It means the eyepiece micrometer 28 division is equal to the stage micrometer 10 division. Okay. Then it is equal. Okay. So right here, B, that is the 10 divisions, and A, that is the 28 division. Then after that, we have to calculate the least count. Okay. What is the least count? See here we can determine the one division of eyepiece micrometer. It means the in between the two lines one division is present, and in between the two lines of eyepiece micrometer that we have to determine. But for determination of least count means it is the one division of stage micrometer. So we have to determine the one division of stage micrometer length. Okay. So see here, stage micrometer scale is 1 millimeter. Okay. Stage micrometer scale is 1 millimeter means the stage micrometer scale is 1 millimeter means it containing the 100 divisions. In 100 divisions, 1 millimeter length is present. Okay. So 1 millimeter is equal to 100 divisions. Okay. So we have to determine the 1 divisions of stage. Okay. So 100 divisions is equal to 1 millimeter, and 1 division of stage micrometer is equal to X. So for calculate, then X is equal to 0.01 millimeter. It means in stage micrometer, 100 division containing the 1 millimeter and 1 division containing the 0.01 millimeter. So we have to convert this 0.01 millimeter to the micrometer. 0.01 millimeter converts into the micrometer, and that is the 10 micrometer. Okay, so we have to write down this 10 micrometer here. This 10 micrometer is called as the least count. Okay, so what is the least count? Least count means it is the one division of the stage micrometer. Okay, so one division of the stage micrometer, it is the 10 micrometer. So write here 10 micrometer. Then the final value is one division of eyepiece micrometer is equal to 3.57 micrometer. This is the calibrated value of the eyepiece micrometer. Okay, so this is the process step of the procedure, that is the mounting of the sample. For that, we have to take a small liquid paraffin on the starch powder. Okay, after that mix this mixture uniformly on the glass slides. After mixing is completed, then avoid the entrapment of the air bubbles. Then place this glass. Apply the cover slip on the surface of the powder sample. After applying the cover slip, then avoid the air bubbles or avoiding the entrapment of the air bubbles. Okay, then place this glass slide on the stage micrometer. Then the third stage of the practical, that is the measurements of the particle size. For measurements of the particle size, we have to set the microscope properly, then counting the number of particles with the help of microscope. Okay, so after we have counting the number of particles, we can distribute that particles. See here, according to this format, first number of eyepiece divisions. Okay, number of eyepiece divisions is 1 division, 2 division, 3 division, 4 division. Okay, so in 1 division of the number of eyepiece, we have to count the number of particles. Okay, so number of eyepiece division 1, we have to multiply with calibrated value. We can determine the calibrated value, that is the 3.57. Okay, so after that multiplication, that is the 3.57. in first division, the number of particle is 10. Then in second division, the number of particle is 19. Then in third division, the number of particles is 18. Okay, so we have to count the number of particles in each division. Okay, and after the number of particles we can count, then we have to determine the, or we can measure when the particle size with the help of this table. Here in this table, the particle size range in between the 1 to 5 micrometer, then 5 to 10 micrometer, then 10 to 15 micrometer. It means we can distribute the particle size in between the ranges, different ranges. And in the different ranges, we have to add the different number of particle size. Okay, so this is the particle size range. Then we can determine the mean size range particle. Mean size range particle means we have to add one. We have to take the mean, okay? We can take the mean of the 1 to 5 range, okay? So 1 to 5 micrometer range, mean size range is the 3. Then 5 to 10, the mean value is 8. 10 to 15, the mean value is 13, okay? Like this manner, we have to calculate this all right. After that, in third column, the number of particles in each size. So in this size range, the number of particles is 8. Then 8 micrometer size range, the number of particles is 19. Then 13 micrometer size range, number of particles is 164. So like this manner, you have to write down the number of counting number of particle size. Okay. Then next column, you have to determine the percent frequency. In percent frequency, you have to take the this summation of n. Summation of n means it is the number of particles in each size. Okay. So the summation is the total of this 225. Okay. So 225 is the 100%. So for the 10% is the x. So x is equals to 100 multiplied by 10 divided by 225. The value is 4.44. So with the help of this summation value, we can determine the percent frequency. Okay. So the percent frequency value is 4.44. Then 8.44. Same, you have to calculate this all value. Okay. Then after the percent frequency, the cumulative percent frequency. For cumulative percent frequency, we have to take the first value as it is. In the first value, you have to add the second value. Okay. In 4.44, you have to add the 8.44. The value is 12.88. Okay. Then again, in this 12.88, you have to add the third value. Same like this manner, you have to write down the cumulative percent frequency. In that next column is the n multiplied by d. See here, the n means the number of particles in each size. This is called as the frequency, and this indicates the symbol n. Okay. N means the number of particles in each size range. D is the mean size range. Okay, this is the mean size range. So you have to multiply this n with d value. Then this all value you have to find out. Okay, then next n multiplied by d square. Okay, you have to take the square of this all value. After that, you have to determine the n multiplied by d cube. Okay, in n multiplied by d cube, here we can take the cube root. Okay, so these are all the cube roots of this value. Okay, then next percent n multiplied by d cube. For percent n multiplied by d cube, we have to use this summation value. Okay, so But this cumulative Poisson frequency, it is called as the number distribution. It is called as the number distribution. And this cumulative Poisson frequency, it is the weight under size. Weight under size means it is the weight distribution. Okay? So first we have to calculate, or first we can determine the number distribution. After that we can determine the weight distribution. Okay? So for weight distribution you have to write down this percent m multiplied by d cube value as it is, that is 0.04. In that this 0.04 value you have to add a 1.52 value. Okay? Then your final value is 1.56. Then in this 1.56 value you have to add this third value. Okay? Like this manner you have to add one by one value in this value. Then this is the cumulative percent frequency. In cumulative percent frequency it is called as the weight distribution. So see here in this experiment, first we can determine the number distribution. We can determine the number distribution with the help of number of particles in each size. Okay? Then that number distribution we can convert into the weight distribution. Okay? So in optical microscopy methods, we have to use number distribution and then we can convert into the weight distribution. So the optical microscope particle size range is 0.2 to 100 micrometer. So in this experiment, the final particle size or all particle size ranges in between the 0.2 to 100 micrometer. See here, these all particle size range are in between the 0.2 to 100 micrometer. It means the formulations or suspensions or immersions containing the particle size